In today's video, I'm going to be taking some calcium acetate I made in the last video and turn it into some flammable jelly. I will then add additional compounds to make the fire burn different colors. I will also be announcing who won my last video at the end, so make sure to stay tuned. This project is pretty simple, and the only two things I really need are alcohol like isopropyl or ethanol, and some dried calcium acetate. To start off, we will take 17 grams of calcium acetate, which I have already added to a beaker. Following this, we will add 30 milliliters of distilled water. I start by breaking up all of the larger chunks, followed by stirring it around. This can take some time to dissolve, though we really want as much to dissolve as possible. And it's inevitable that there will be some undissolved powder left. This is fine and won't really matter. Though we could filter off the solution, I just allow the particles to sink to the bottom and to decant the upper water layer. Next, we'll pour about 170 milliliters of isopropyl alcohol into a beaker. I'm using 91% isopropyl alcohol, which means there is 9% water. This ratio is really important because if you use too much water, the jelly will not form as well as you would like. Ultimately, it just dilutes the solution and turns everything back into a liquid. This is what actually happened to me the first time because I thought I bought 99% isopropyl alcohol. Even that extra 9% changed it completely. After all of the particles have sunk to the bottom, we decant our water and calcium acetate into the alcohol, and we instantly see some of the jelly start to crash out of solution. What is happening here is a stable mixture of liquid and solid particles holding together to form a jelly. Add in the calcium acetate and stir after every addition. This will give you a complete control about the consistency of the jelly you want to make. After three additions, the jelly will start to take over the liquid and we can see nice chunks start to form. This is where I stopped, but you can continue to add calcium acetate until it firms up a bit. However, this will ultimately make each piece burn for slightly less time. We can see that I made a very nice consistency that is still jelly and wet, but I can crush it with my fingers pretty easily. I left this for a few days covered, and when I came back, it was less jelly-like, but this is okay and it'll still work for what I'm doing. If I left this uncovered, the alcohol and water would eventually evaporate and the jelly would just turn back into an oxidized calcium acetate. We next add some of the jelly to a small cauldron I found at a craft store and thought it would be a perfect fit for this. I just add a random amount and really don't measure things out. Following this, I add a mixture of aluminum and copper sulfate to the jelly, and when it burns, it should give it a nice, beautiful green color. With this, I also just add a random amount and can always continue to add jelly or more aluminum and copper sulfate to make it the consistency I want. Following this, make sure to stir the two components together well. When we first light the jelly, everything burns and no colors appear right away. This is because the copper sulfate and aluminum aren't burning yet. It is mostly just the fumes from the alcohol at this point. Though, as things start to heat up, we start to see green in the flames come out. And when I turn the lights off and relight it, it is more than cool. Honestly, I watched this for a while just enjoying the colors. Putting it out is relatively easy as well, and all you have to do is smother the flame. And to do this, I just use a round bottom flask and it goes out right away. Anyways, that's all I have to say for this project, but there is so much more fun to be had. On the screen now, I show the winners for my last contest and look out for a message in your emails. Unfortunately, a few of my winners were outside of the country, which makes it hard to ship. Still look out for a message in your inbox over the next few days though. Next, you can see my Patreon subscribers here, and I really appreciate everything. Very soon, I'm going to have to restock on some essential reagents to be able to make more videos about chemistry and science in general. The money I receive from my Patreon subscribers is what I do this with, so thank you guys so much for helping produce my videos with me, and without you, I really couldn't do it. Finally, you see a list of all of my future videos I'm currently working on. I should have a video out every about 2 to 3 weeks because good content takes longer to film and edit, which really makes it worth it. And until next time, have a great rest of your day.